Hi Devyanshu, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
How are you doing?
Sir, fine.
Fine, okay, let me start video. Okay. I guess we'll wait for some time for other people to join if they want to.
Sir, actually, this is my first class.
Oh, this is your first class. Okay. You were not present in the last class. All right. So what do you know about machine learning? I'll just give you a recap of the last session.
Sir, actually, it is a way that we teach machines to perform certain activities
Okay.
for us.
But isn't that keep your mom mic on because there's nobody outside. So, but isn't that what every machine does, right? Every machine makes your task easier.
Yes, sir.
Between machine learning and a normal machine.
But sir, we teach them to do calculations, set up calculations for us.
Certain calculation. Okay, give me an example then.
Sir, like if you want to calculate the distance from one star to another, it would be tough if we do it on our own.
Okay, let's say I'm an architect. Let's say I'm an architect. That may be size of a plot or something like that, right? That's what architects do.
Yes, sir. Sir, actually, you're not audible.
Not audible.
अब आ रही आवाज, पहले नहीं आ रही थी.
हम एक प्लॉट के डायमेंशंस ले रहे हैं बीइंग एन आर्किटेक्ट और अ सिविल इंजीनियर व्हिचएवर सर. तो उसमें हम क्या करें, व्हाट विल मशीन लर्निंग डू स्पेसिफिकली?
सर, उसमें मतलब हमें जो भी बनाना है सर, उसके हम डायमेंशन सर, लेंथ पे ब्रेथ और हाइट जो होती है सर, वो कैलकुलेट करेंगे, उसका एक डिजाइन बनाएंगे.
आप ना अपनी डेली लाइफ में मशीन लर्निंग यूज करते हैं कहीं ना कहीं? फिंगरप्रिंट स्कैनर, योर फोन माइट हैव फेस रिकॉग्निशन सॉफ्टवेयर इन इट. सो ऑल दीज इज बेस्ड ऑन मशीन लर्निंग.
यस सर.
सो व्हाट दे डू इज दे डोंट एक्चुअली कैलकुलेट थिंग्स. व्हाट दे डू इज इन मशीन लर्निंग वी फीड डेटा इनटू द सिस्टम और टू द मशीन एंड इट लर्न्स द पैटर्न बिटवीन द इनपुट एंड द आउटपुट. दैट्स व्हाट इट डज मोस्टली. बट इफ यू एंड इन बिटवीन देर इज सम एल्गोरिथम रनिंग which enables the machine to find the pattern depending on what kind of patterns do you want to find. Like for the face recognition, you want to find patterns between what's the distance between your nose and your eyes and things like that. And let's say for something else, like say for voice recognition, it feeds these sound waves to the machine and it finds pattern in it, right? So that is
Yes,
what.
sir.
So machine learning is not just the calculations, because if you know the calculation of certain things, then machine is not required for it, or machine learning is not. It hasn't. It doesn't need to learn anything as such, right?
Yes, sir.
So, why machine learning only comes into picture when you have something which you don't know how to calculate. First of all, let's say the example that you were discussing. Yeah, hi, Arav, were you present in the last session? And Arab is on mute. Okay. So Divyanshu, so what will happen is we feed the machine the images of the plots, right? And we feed the dimensions of the plot to the machine so that it can scale the distance between two points with respect to the photos. So that's where it learns something that you don't know. That like you and me would not have any idea looking at five pictures at a time and calculating the distance between two points.
Yes, sir.
So machine finds.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, were you present in the last session?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so then we were just discussing what machine learning is because Divyanshu was not present in the last session. So okay, I think we'll start in like 2 minutes because I don't know whether anybody else is joining or not. So in the last session, Divyanshu, what we did, we discussed the machine learning first. Then we went through different types of machine learning in which we discussed. After the session, we will have 5 or 10 minutes in between two of us, and I'll explain what it is. And then we were trying to simulate some examples, but unfortunately, the network had some issue and I was not able to do it. So what we will do is we'll make some small machine learning programs today, not really programs. We'll be using a portal called Scratch. What it enables you to do is it has all the controls of a programming into blocks, and you arrange those blocks, you know, onto your graphical user interface. And from there, we will make some program running. Divyanshu, you have background in programming?
No, sir.
No programming.
सर एक मेरे मामा हैं जो मतलब है इसमें कोडिंग प्रोग्रामिंग में, बट ऐसे कुछ खास उनके साथ मतलब इंटरेक्शन है नहीं मेरे, तो मैं कुछ बता नहीं सकता. सर बस वही, और कोई नहीं है. सर 11th.
So have you opted for CS?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And going forward, not today, of course, but in some time, we'll delve into Python, and we will cover machine learning from Python perspective as well. For the time being, we'll be discussing a GUI at most for some time. So we have a good grasp on what machine learning is, and going forward, we'll move on to Python and we'll import our machine learning data to it. Okay, so I guess we'll start.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let me just share my screen. Okay. This will stop. Okay, yes. Okay, so all right. So, okay, I'll share. How do I hide this?
Yeah.
Okay, so what I will do is we will be using two portals mainly one portal. We'll be using this portal called Machine Learning for Kids. It's a program run by in England, and what they do is they provide you a easy to use interface to develop your machine learning models. And from then on, we'll move on to some. This is the GUI that I was talking about. Let me just remove this. Okay. So this is the GUI. What we'll go through is we'll go through a Pac-Man game today. We'll develop a Pac-Man, and the computer will play Pac-Man. It will learn how you play it, and from then point onwards, it will play on its own. And then we will discuss another program, and we'll just use some emojis on your face or my face for this case. Just like that, only two examples of it. It will take some time to develop this. So just to see what it means, I'll show you this, that this was something I made, and okay, it will start playing. It should, okay, why did it not, okay, it is playing now, right? So see, the program is playing on its own. Have any one of you?
Yes, sir.
You have idea about what Pac-Man is, right?
Yes, sir.
What about? Arab?
Yes, sir.
You have idea about what Pac-Man game is?
Yes, sir.
So what we'll do is I'll share these things too. Just a second. Let it just move on. Okay, I have. So we have some documentation regarding the same. So we'll go with the Pac-Man, and we'll go one step by step. So for Divyanshu, we went through this in the last session. So what we have here is that we make some projects. I have made a project called Pac-Man game. And what we do is we train this with some data. Not in this case. In this case, the data will come from the program to the backend, and then from this the machine runs on this. Like machine knows when to go left and when to go right depending on this data. What this data is, this data is basically the coordinates of the your Pac-Man and the ghost, right? There are only two entities in this game, ghost who is running after you and Pac-Man is you who is trying to evade him.
Yes, sir.
What it shows is that when it is a 0-0-0, the decision should be, it should go left and right. How did this data came into picture? We'll go through this. So, okay, what I would do is I would create, I will open this link in different portal or different browser. The reason being is that I need to show you from scratch, right? Okay. Okay, so I'll get started and so we'll go through the documentation first. So we will have some idea what we are trying to do, okay? So the whole idea is to, first of all, teach machine what steps to take and when to take it. And depending on that, it will develop its certain model that it will try to play on its own, but it depends how good you play it, how good the data was when you fed into the system, right? Like when your phone is reading the fingerprint scanner, if you don't put in the right data for your fingerprints, then it will not be working later on, right? That happens a lot. Like your finger gets smudged with something and it doesn't work anymore.
Yes, sir. It happens.
It happens even for the face. We found in COVID times that with the mask on, it sometimes it doesn't even recognize your face.
Yes, sir.
So it depends on the amount of data that you have fed. So what happened with COVID is that people did not expect that people will be wearing masks. So what happened? It didn't recognize people wearing masks first. But if you see nowadays, it is able to recognize a lot of faces. The reason being is that new data came into the system when it could relay faces with masks as well. Okay, hi, somebody else has joined? No. Okay, so this is the whole idea of this picture is to play Pac-Man. So what we'll do, we'll create a project. We have templates in it. I'll show you the templates. So you can get project templates from here. There's a lot of projects. So Pac-Man is a number-based project. Is that in the sense that it runs on numbers, right? X, Y coordinates and then it does something. So this is the Pac-Man template. What template does is it basically creates some commands for you, some interface for you, and then you can change it according to your own machine learning model. Divyanshu, can you understand this Scratch? Do you understand what I'm trying to say in the Scratch, this portal? Am I audible? Divyanshu?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. Divyanshu, are you there? Have you left? Okay. I guess Divyanshu has left. Okay, Arav, you have already have the idea of the Scratch, right? We discussed.
Yes, sir.
So what we'll try is we'll create a, first of all, a system. We'll create a new project, maybe this. And we gave my game, let's name it my game, okay? And we'll be working with numbers. So when you talk about numbers, then it needs to find out what kind of numbers are you looking for. So I give some values to it. Let's say I'll say Pac-Man X. It will be of number. The X is just the X coordinate of the Pac-Man because we are dealing in two dimensional things only. And we will give a Pac-Man Y. This will also be a number. Then Y. The other entity is ghost, of course. So ghost X. And ghost Y. So we will be dealing only in four numbers. Okay, we'll create this project.
हेलो सर।
हाय दिव्यांश
सर, एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस, नाउ यू आर
ऑडिबल। यस सर।
We are making a machine learning project. First of all, we discuss that it for a number based project what we are dealing with, because we'll be discussing x y coordinates mainly, and that's how the things are going to move. So we created a machine learning project for numbers, but the numbers project requires you to feed in what kind of numbers is it looking for, what kind of variables it is looking for. So it is only looking for four variables. One is the x and two are the x and y coordinates of the Pac-Man, and the xy coordinates of the ghost, right? There are only two entities running in the whole system.
Yes, sir.
We go to this and then we create main. Okay, the difference is we are not going to feed data directly to the machine learning. We are going to play some game on the other portal, and that data will automatically get synced back to the machine learning model. So you will see those tables as we play. Let me just, okay, this is taking a lot of time. Let's say I'm using Scratch 3. You can use Python, you can use Scratch. And you can use Scratch Python. Okay, why is it not saying? Okay, I have to create labels for the movement. Like Pac-Man can go up, down, left or right, right? So I have to give, we will discuss these in detail. Just let me just put these on and I'll explain through the other thing. Left or right, or it decides to go up or down, right? Why is my screen suddenly? Where did that down go? I did add that, right? Did I not?
Sir, मतलब इसके बाद क्या?
We have four decisions that we have to take. We either go left, right, up, or down. That's all our Pac-Man can do.
Yes, sir.
Now we'll go to make, because we didn't have that labels. We'll again choose Scratch 3. It will say that you have no model, you haven't really put it into work. So it will ask you to straight into Scratch. Either you can get data from the Scratch playing that game, or you can get data from yourself. You can put that data in yourself. We'll discuss that in a way, in another project. So this is the UI that it creates. So for now, we have to get the template. So I'll get the template of the Pac-Man. It will just, okay. So we have something going on. Now let's go back to the tutorial and the, okay. So what we have done is we skipped this part. We created a project. We created these things. We learned left, right, top, bottom. And then we moved on to Scratch. And then we have, okay, this. And we entered the template, right?
Yes.
What it says is, okay, now this game is, where did it go? Okay. This game is currently configured to be played by you. And you have to play it yourself, because otherwise there is no way to feed data to the system. Like self-driven cars, right? What kind of data do you think it got in the start? You have heard about Tesla cars, right?
No, sir.
Might not have.
That means Tesla cars, yes, sir. Auto-driven cars?
So what do you think, what kind of data do we need for auto-driven cars for them to work, for them to
like the speed, distance,
or okay, how do you think Google Maps works?
सर गूगल मैप, फिर गूगल मैप्स चेक्स अराउंड द सराउंडिंग यूजिंग द सैटेलाइट एंड देन क्रिएट द मैप.
क्रिएट शो सैटेलाइट. यस ओके. एंड हाउ डू यू थिंक इट शोज, हाउ मच टाइम विल इट टेक यू टू रीच फ्रॉम एक्स पॉइंट टू वाई पॉइंट?
सर इट टेक्स डिस्टेंस एंड द ट्रैफिक and measures the distance. मतलब कि मतलब सर कितना distance है and फिर उसके बाद कितना traffic हो सकता है, उन सबको मिला के सर वो ऐसे time calculate करके बता सर.
And okay, just the distance and the number of cars, is that all it is doing?
नहीं सर, सर और भी कुछ होता होगा पता नहीं.
I don't know if you ever have you ever been into a traffic jam that just was standing still?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
What was the Google map showing to you? It was showing red.
Yes sir. Red line.
I'll tell you an incident from my life. I was in Gurgaon once, nearby Delhi. I'm not sure whether all of you guys are from Delhi or not. So there's a nearby city. I was there in my office, and a rain came falling down heavily. And what happened was people can't go, so basically broke down. So Google Maps was showing me blue from that city to Delhi, but in reality, what was going on was every car, it wasn't moving anywhere, so it couldn't judge whether there's a traffic or not. Like Google automatically discards the car standing by on the sides, right? It has to.
Yes, sir.
What happened was, because every car was standing still, it showed me red blue that the path is very clear, and it took me 8 hours to reach from Gurgaon to Delhi. So that is where machine learning fails, because it runs on certain parameters. It runs on the parameter that car will be moving somewhat slower, maybe faster, but at some speed, some change will be happening, but nothing was going on. So that is how machine learning works. It feeds the data, the real-time data or the past data. What it does is, let's say you have a phone. Now you move from, where do you look, Divyanshu?
Noida extension.
Oh, you know good now. So Noida extension to, you are coming to Noida from Noida extension to Delhi. So let's say you take the toll road.
Yes, sir.
Now one day you decided that I won't take that toll road, but I'll take some other route. We have other borders of Noida and Delhi from this Kalindi and things like that, right?
Yes, sir.
What will happen is Google will automatically read that you are using some other route to reach that specific destination. So it will add that route on its own if enough people take that route.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. If we change our direction, it shows a new route.
That's why Google does not generally recommend you inside lanes. It generally shows you the broader picture of the things or the main route.
Yes, sir.
If you are stuck, it will start fetching those lanes for you. So that is how machine learning works. A lot of data gets fed into the system, and from that data, it decides the output. It knows the output that, okay, you are reaching from X to Y, and this was the input, that this is the route you took. Why did you change it? Was there a traffic there? And there were a lot of things that is going on. That is from, it is predicting what route you should take. That's how it recommends you a route. So there's a lot of data going on. So what we'll do is, the Pac-Man is similar to it. We'll play a game, and of course the system will find the route, how it should move, to avoid that ghost. And from their point onwards, it will play on its own. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So, okay. So what we'll do is, we'll give this stage and write up and constant. We'll change this. And we'll modify this. Why would we modify it? Because, okay, what will we modify first? We will see, okay, where is it? next slide go. And click back my next slide to this. Okay, just a second. I'm not able to find this. Click on this. Okay. So we, okay. So in last class, we discussed this, that when we create a machine learning project from that portal and comes to this part, it automatically adds a blocks for you, which is your machine learning course, like left, right, up and down. We added this in here. Let me show you. We added these labels, left, right, up and down. So you can see these labels, how to, which number it should recognize, whether it should move left, right, or up and down, right? So what it says is, you modify this script according to your parameters, because what it is saying is, if you see closely, you will see it is just saying left. This is nothing. This is just a text, right? So what we have to do is with our own variables. Okay. My mouse is apparently not really working. So we'll feed data to these. What it is saying is feed data to these variables in the background. Okay. Okay. We'll move on. Then it says, go to the decision making. So this is where the game is actually getting played. This is where it, the decision to Pac-Man, where to move is coming into picture. So apparently here it is doing nothing. So what it asks you is to change this to feed your own data. So I'll show you something else. Okay, any doubts or anything that you are not able to understand, please feel free to discuss with me. There is no exams that are going to be conducted on this, but it would be nice.
No, sir. Matlab hame drag and drop karke values put karni hai.
Matlab haan, drag and drop karke, but hame samajhte ho chal raha hai, but not just drag and drop. We'll there are two ways we can go about it. Either we create it step by step. Okay, let's create this one step by step, and next one we'll discuss in details. All right, does that work?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what it says is you have to add training data to it. Okay, apparently my mouse is, okay. Now still you can see it is 0000, right? So what it says is change these to your own variables. How will you find these variables? You will find this here. You added these variables, right? Ghost X, Ghost Y, Pac-Man S, Pac-Man Y. So Pac-Man X will replace, okay. I'll use my touch practice. Okay, I'll just this and back to Y and X and Y. Okay, now this is not left. What it says is it should be your next man move. Depending on this, if we are choosing a next man. Okay. Now what it says, train the computer by playing the game. So we'll play this game. So I'll play, the post is moving, I'm not moving, I'll try to move and I will die. Okay, the post is, my target for feeding this data is to run as long as I can.
Yes, sir.
I can stop and I can die. I just wait and okay. It will go moving in certain direction because that's how Pac-Man works. Maybe. What happened? Why is it not dying? Did I stop it? ओके बिकॉज वी आर रनिंग अ फ्री पोर्टल एंड वी आर रनिंग वेरी स्मॉल थिंग्स सो व्हाट इट डज इज इट बेसिकली इज व्हाई इज इट सो स्लो आई वाज जस्ट रनिंग इट राइट Did I miss some part? No, I did not, right? It's weird. It's stopping after the ride. Should not. Okay, let us die. Oh, it did not die. Okay, so one move is done. We have played it one time. Now we play again. We'll play two or three times at max. And I'll show you how does the data come into picture. Okay, again we are dead. One more time. As you can see, some programs blocks are getting highlighted when I press something or do something, right? If you can
see. Yes, yes.
So what it is doing is it even, okay. So I have played it three times and apparently I have died in less than 12. Okay. I will save this project first. Okay, it is on. Yes, that's weird. Anyway. As you can see, okay, I did not press down button a lot. I pressed only once, I guess. So now as you can see, it has a lot of data for left and right, right?
Because
yes, sir. That way. And because I was not pressing down button a lot, what happened was I don't have a lot of data for down. So machine will not be able to decide when to go down because it has only one specific coordinates that when Pac-Man is at 5-2, then Iron Ghost is at 4-2, then move down. So we'll play once more and we'll put in some down data. We'll go up first. Let it start. We'll go down. And we'll go one more time down. And we'll run. I'm just putting in some data for it. That's why I'm going this weird way. Okay, time to die. Hopefully it will kill me. Yes. Okay, we'll go back and we'll once again look at the data. We'll see some more data in down because I press E. Okay. As you can see, we can see some down data now. So what we were doing for now was feeding the system the moves that we make, how we play it. That's how everybody learns Pac-Man, right? You see someone play some game, you see some tutorial how to play it, and then you play on your own.
Yes, sir.
That's what we are teaching the machine. So what it says is, okay, you do this and training tool. Now, as you can see, we saw a lot of data and we'll go and okay. Now it says is that go to this place and learn. Okay. So what we did for now, there are three steps in machine learning for machine learning programs. First of all, you need to train the machine is that you have to feed the data to the system that what it is trying, what pattern it is trying to find. Then you tell the machine, okay, run your own algorithms. Now these algorithms are written by these people. These are not written by us. so they will run on their own and we'll just click on this machine. Okay, so it is now trained. As you can see bottom, you will see that model started training and it is available now. Okay, so we'll go back and what we will do is this vector project, click on this page, and now we need to do a few things. It says you can delete, you don't need to delete things. You just need to we are here anyway, and it says that you should delete these. Now these steps were when you are pressing keys, right? But it depends if you are pressing the keys or not. It says if you, okay, we'll go to back to this project. It says that when you press up key, Pac-Man should go up and right and left, and the similar examples of left arrow key when you press this. But these are only valid when you are pressing keys. So what we'll do is we can just stop pressing keys and we bypass this step. And okay, and when we go, and now we need, what we need to do, the main thing. Now we'll come to the machine learning part, how to use a machine learning. What it says is that you need to redefine the decision making part of the code, right? Okay, any doubts? Or am I going too fast, too slow?
No, sir.
Everything is clear to everyone? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we will redefine this game, redefine this decision making, not game. What it says is that you will always find this part is already present. We were training data through this this year, right? We would just said that, okay, train data depending on this. So what we'll do is we'll just not remove this, we'll use this in some way. So what it says is now instead of training that model, you plan the next move depending on what is the outcome of this machine learning algorithm. Okay, so what does the machine learning algorithm say? I'll just zoom in. Can I zoom in? I hope I can. Okay, so what you see is you need to plan your next move based on. I don't know how to. Can I edit it? No. Depending on this, okay, what is this? First of all, if you go to this part, you will see something. First one, I'll just drop and drop back. This is the recognize part. What is it recognizing? It is recognizing what is x value, what is y value, what is goes x value, and what is y value. Right? The other one you can leave it. This one we have already used, right? This says add training data. It is adding that training data to the system. And we are not training a new model. If you add new data, you have to train it. If you want to train it from scratch, you can just drag and drop this here and you can do it. Or you can go back and go to learn and train it. So there are two ways you can do it here. All right. So we'll change this according to how do we change it. It says you need to set something. So what way will you find set? Okay, we will set this. Okay, I hope I can draw that up. Just put this out and put this in. What I need to do next, back right? So we can use some things out of it. So recognize this. What patterns does it need to recognize? What is the value of pattern X? What is the value of pattern Y? Post X, post Y. Okay, post Y just went back. Oh, Y. I and now we can just okay. So we have set this part. Now, okay, one more part. Modify the kings only want the script to end. Okay, so what we will do is it says that how you now for now what we were doing was we were playing with ourselves, right? This part. So what it says is first of all remove this. Okay, I have to find this and this part, and this can go away. And anything else? I don't think anything else is needed. Broadcast. Okay. Okay. We should be able to have something. Wow. But why did our program did not go? Did I miss something? No. I missed something, I guess. This is fine. Pac-Man is in. Pac-Man goes home. That was way too fast. Okay. I'll just debug this later. Anyway, this is the same game, right? Is anybody available now? Okay. Okay, Divyanshu and Arab. You guys are available, right?
Yes, sir. We are.
Okay. Yes. How are we able to understand or we can go block by block? We can discuss it. So what it is doing for now? Okay. Did you understand this part where we fed the data to the system?
Yes, sir.
So what it says is from then point onwards, what it says is your Pac-Man decision initially, okay, I'll just reload this. So we have two different sets of, I'll just reload it. Okay. So what it says is that first of all, your Pac-Man decision making was empty, right? There was no decision that Pac-Man was taking. The Pac-Man decision was taken by you depending on these parameters. When you pressed on the up arrow, then it moved to up direction and it moved to right and left and down and left. Okay. Now what you do is you change the decision based on how is your ghost moving, right? So it recognizes where is Pac-Man, where is ghost, and what my next move should be. This is entirely based on this data. This data shows is you go left when Pac-Man is on block X of Y coordinate and block zero of Y coordinate and ghost is at X and Y. So ghost is at zero and zero. Okay. Now, if it is not understandable, please raise your voice.
No, sir, it is understandable.
What about you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, these are very small examples of what a machine learning program is, right? This is very small example. What you did, you played a certain game. You moved around in that game and the system learned how you should move around to play this game. It has no idea what it is doing. What it knows is your inputs that, okay, these were the coordinates and the output. You took a left on this part. When these were the coordinates, you took a right on this part. So left, right, top and down are the final predictions, what the system should do. Now these left, right, top and down can be anything, right? like your fingerprint. It should know, okay, fingerprint is a bad example. Let me find some other prediction examples. What kind of predictions can we talk about? Like Tesla cars, right? So Tesla cars will work on, obviously there will be more coordinates, but it will work on some coordinates, right? If the road is banked at this angle and the car is going at this speed, then it should steer this wheel at this angle. Right, that is your prediction. That is the final prediction of a Tesla car.
Okay, sir.
If that doesn't make sense, you can please speak. Does that make sense to you? How Tesla cars would work?
Yes, sir.
And how your face recognition would work? Would you like to, anybody would, of two of you would like to try how face recognition would work?
Sir, if Pac-Man moves one step left, the ghost will not move.
I was not able to understand aap kya keh rahe the, but Pac-Man, nahi, we were not talking about Pac-Man anymore. We discussed Pac-Man just to see a very redundant and a very, very small example of what machine learning can be, right? At your level. But let's say, how would you, do you think your face recognition works? How does your phone recognize your face?
Sir, it looks at the different angles, like the face cuttings, and captures an image of it.
And how does it know what face is?
Sir, it uses facial captures of your face, then it detects, is that the same person, and then it opens the...
You think it does that? You do that. Yeah, like, Aram would, you know my face now, right? You have seen me. If you see me in different video call, of course, you might not be able to recognize me in real life. But let's say I'm on a different session. I'm giving you some other, some other lecture in some other department. Let's say I'm teaching Python somewhere else, right? You will recognize my face because you have seen me, right? So how do you think you do that? I'll show you an example based on it. I have an example ready for it, but I just want to see what your thoughts are.
So can you please repeat? Actually, my data was not.
Okay. I'm saying that, okay, I have taken this session. You have seen my face now. Now, let's say tomorrow you see me taking up some other session. Let's say Python or Java or something else. So you will recognize my face in that session, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, because the brain remembers your face.
How do you think the brain remembers? What does it do?
So it saves all the captures of the face, and then it matches with the memory and...
Okay. It matches with the memory, okay. And now let's say I cover this part of my face, right? No, but that would be bad for my voice. Okay, I cover this part, right? Would you be able to recognize me still?
Yes, sir.
But if the other person has the same facial structure as my bottom part of the face, would you be able to do it?
No, sir.
Why not?
No, sir.
Okay. So machine learning was a very crucial part of face recognition system. What happened was, as humans, we always knew how, we always knew we can identify faces, right? But we never knew how we did it. How did we recognize it? Like, if I can see your faces, then how do I recognize your face? What patterns do I inbuilt in my memory or in my mind or my neural network or whatever you can call it? How do I do it? So I'll show you an example. There's another one that I was setting it up. I hope it has not. Okay, it is looking still. Let me just put on the camera. Okay, please turn on the camera. stopped or something. We can make another one, that's not an issue, but there is something wrong with it can't okay. I have to stop my camera here, otherwise it will not work. It's just common UI, right? How do I stop my camera? Stop video. Let's see now. That is not working. Okay, this is an easy one idea. So let me just create something. What we'll do is, okay, we will put an emoji on our face, on my face apparently. You can see my screen, right?
Yes, sir.
Now what I do is I go back to code. I'll add some extensions. I need video sensing to enable the video. And I need face recognition. Enable the face recognition. Now I'll just code block it, and I'll let it do is this and video and non video. That transparent it. Zero. Just move it. And then. Because there is a trigonometry going on here, so I have to find that too. And now just we do this. You can without this control as well forever. Okay. What we do, set size, we don't need it. Set X and Y. Okay, we just need to set X and Y. Where did it go? Okay. Can you see the smiley moving along?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just let me put this smiley a little bit smaller. So we have something better than what we have for now. Is it? Okay. Why? Okay, let's see what our code is. Why is it not taking my nose correctly? Okay. Now let's say I change this to my left eye. Okay, this is weird. And either it is not sensing me properly, or my emoji costume is.
So your emoji is a little bit.
Sir, off position.
Oh, I can make it smaller, but that won't change anything. What I'm saying is that it is not really at the correct position.
Yes, sir.
Oh, but I haven't done anything more really complicated. Left eye. Let's move it to right eye. See if it is correctly. It is off.
जो आपका इमोजी है वो ना उसमें एक सेंटर सी बॉल बनी है, सिर्फ अगर आप उसके ऊपर करोगे ना तब वो शायद से दिखाएगा
सेंटर बॉल। Okay, I'll just move it here. Okay, you are right. Let us do that. And pad space. Okay, pad space. Oh, come on, mouse. But it's still up, right? This is what you're saying, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, how does it work? How do you think one of my eyes coming in? One of my eyes is coming like a smiley.
At first, it recognizes your face and then matches it with its memory.
Yes, but how do you think it knows my this is my eye and this is my nose? Let's keep it at a mouth. Just keep it at that looks much better. Okay, how do you think it is recognizing my nose, mouth, and eyes? That's a wild guess. Any guess would work, right?
So no idea.
Arab, would you like to try?
Sir, no idea.
No idea. So, as we saw here, right, we have a data. What we did here is we used some extensions, of course. There are some extensions given by these people. They provide you for music, text to speech, speech to text. You can also go through pages of Wikipedia and you can translate. You have seen translate at a lot of places. Hand detection, position, filter. What are all these? These extensions are basically our pre-learned machines. Pre-learned, what I mean by pre-learned is it already knows that if this is the, let's see if we can get a picture of it. Face detection. Okay, let me just face detection and let me just find out images. I'll find, okay. Can you see this image?
Yes, sir.
What it does is, we feed the system these images and we tell it that these coordinates are for eyes, left eye, this is for the right eye, these are the eyebrows, these are the nose, and this is the mouth, and this is the face structure. We feed this data to the system first. There are a lot of data that is fed to the system first. When did the face recognition software came into more into commercial use? Is when Facebook got invented, right? Facebook has a lot of data. With social media explosion, what we saw is there's a lot of your video data, your basically media data is getting fed into the system. So what they did is they did it for like 1,000 photos. When they found out, okay, these are the eye, these are the, this is the mouth, and this is the coordinates for the face. You can do these points in Photoshop or any software that you like. And if I give you some other better examples, so, if I can see something. Okay, these are all points. So it is not really doing something. Okay. So it finds out where that image goes. So now it maps the pattern between these points. Okay, so this is the face, this is the color change, so this is something else. Somebody mentioned this is these are the hair, and this is the mouth. And so it creates a pattern in it. If you feed it enough images, let's say you fed it like 2000 images and you labeled these things. You have to label this. You have to tell the system, this is the nose, this is the mouth, this is the eyes. After 1000 or such images, what it does is it can detect your eyes, nose, and your face because there is a lot of similarity between these patterns, right? A nose remains something like a nose in most of the humans, right? Unless until your eye is damaged, your eyes will look the same. There will be some white part, there will be some colorful part in the middle of the eye, and there be some patterns here that it is rising up and it is going down, and these are the cut, right? These patterns, you and me see it on daily basis. We have this programmed into us that we can find patterns like this, just like how we find voices of people. You can recognize my voice over the phone as well, because you have listened to my voice texture or the pattern in my voice sign wave, right? So that is how machine also learns. That is how you learn as well. That's Divyanshu, you were not present in the last class, but we discussed this, that machine learning works on the same pattern as humans learn. That there is no difference as such, except that you are a tremendously amazing machine and you can do a lot of things. You can learn a lot of things, very, very complicated things. A machine is not really up to that level for now, but in future it can. It might reach that level.
Yes, sir.
Right. So you can break down the problem in your head. If you can find the pattern in your head, you can code any machine because you know the pattern. All you need to do is put in the data and you know the output. So let's say you want to predict like betting sites, right? Anybody has gone through betting sites or something like that?
No, sir.
But you...
No, sir.
Okay. Are two of you a fan of cricket or football?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Which one?
The football.
The cricket.
Very different people. All right. So I am sure about cricket that I have seen this. You might have seen this as well, Arav. I'll show you something on ESPN Cricket Info, does it? Okay, apparently my website is not opening. Yes, this site is down. That's after a long time. Okay, does that too? Okay, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Why am I audible to you guys and I can't open any of these sites? Okay, this is open, finally. Okay. Let me see, do they show win percentage here somewhere? They used to do it for IPL. I have seen that part. Okay, they are not doing it for this game. More stats. Okay, I can't see it. I thought they had this here. And statistics table. Okay, they have you seen on TV or something there's a win percentage going on?
Yes, sir.
Percentage.
Yes, sir.
Goes for football as well.
It predicts stage.
Yes. Let's see if some game is going on. Okay, there is no UEFA. Okay, Czech Republic and England match. Okay. Okay. So those percentages are calculated by machine learning algorithms. What they do is they feed the entire data that they have. That okay, this player is playing. Like for football, which team are you a fan of? Divyanshu.
Juventus.
Juventus. Okay, let's say Ronaldo is playing, right? Ronaldo is still at Juventus, right?
Yes, sir.
Let's say Ronaldo is playing, and let's say. Who else? Kellini is there or Kellini has left?
Sir, he has left.
Okay, tell me another name.
Sir, another. Sir, Paul Odiwala.
Oh, yeah. I think I have not followed football for a long time now. Okay, let's say Kellini was there or Buffon was there. Buffon is
yes, sir, yes.
So, Kellini would do what the presence of Kellini will automatically increase the chances of not conceding a goal, right?
Yes, sir.
So what it will do is Kellini played this many games and these are the goals that he has blocked.
Yes, sir. Successful tackles.
Successful tackles and the other notes as well. Like Kellini is not the only guy who is defending it, right? There are other people around him. So
yes,
combination of all of those data will predict some percentage of how many goals they are going to concede. And that's the general pattern, right? That's the general prediction that a machine can do. It's an unbiased prediction.
It yes.
That Killini is your favorite player or not. It doesn't need to take into account that Killini has been, good form recently. It takes into account all the data. And for similarly for Ronaldo, it governs that, okay, this is the combination of the midfield that is playing. So Ronaldo would have this much chances of scoring one goal or two goals, right?
Yes, sir.
And that's how in cricket as well. Like if Virat Kohli is playing, that the system knows that if he plays in these conditions against these bowlers, that this is the average of runs he can score in general. So that's what it will predict. And of course, I am simplifying the data. There's a lot of other data, like what stage the match is, who is the position bowler, how old is the ball, and who is the companion partner at the other end. And there's a lot of data that is going on. But if you talk about in a simpler way, then this is how it works. Let me just get back on my video. Okay. Am I visible? I don't think so.
No, sir.
Okay. So then I was right that if one of these things is using the... Okay, let me just... And now I think I should be visible. And where did I go? Yes. Now I'm visible, right? Okay. So because we were using the same hardware, the webcam, as the program, so it was not enabling me to enable the video. So I am simplifying the data, right? Virat Kohli will have a lot of other data. So will Ronaldo will have a lot of data. So will Messi have a lot of data for football. If you follow football, then Argentina match will be coming up later on. So accumulating all that data, what it needs to predict is very simple things. It has to predict how many goals they are going to score and how many goals they are going to concede. It doesn't care about anything else. So although the output is only two-dimensional in the sense that how many, there are two things only that it is predicting, how many goals it is going to score and how many goals are they going to concede. But to come to that decision, it has to take into account a lot of patterns, a lot of data, just like here we saw, right? In this case, right? We took a lot of data, varying on only four variables, but a lot of data to predict one simple output, whether it will go left, right, top or down, or top or, okay, what did, down, yes. Right? So, what it is finding is, it is finding pattern between inputs and output. That pattern is governed by different algorithms. We will not be discussing a lot of algorithms in detail because they are very pretty complicated for your level. Let's say we delve into a lot of detail of it, then it will become very boring and it will become too academic to really enjoy what machine learning is. So we will move on from this to some other portals and we will move on to something like this that you will see codes like this, some of these screens, black and whites. But for the time being, we'll start with this. Is that okay with you guys? That moving forward, we'll be programming here and we'll be learning on the side some Python.
Yes.
Okay, I think my agenda for today was just to go through some simulations, just to make you aware what machine learning can do. And the any idea that you can come up with, I'll share you these links. You can implement them here if you want to. Please don't neglect your other studies, but if you have some time and you want to explore what machine learning is, you can play around with in these programs and you can do some things. Like this can be anything. Pac-Man was just an example. You can make that snake game. It also goes left, right, top, and bottom, not down, right?
Yes, sir.
and you can make a football game. You can make anything. It depends. You had just have to choose the right labels, the right data, and the right output that you want to do. So there are n number of things that you can do with it. The real life examples are pretty complicated, but for your level, you can start with these small programs. You can think a lot of other things. You will find a lot of YouTube videos on these platform, and you will find a lot of examples what children can do and what across the world people are doing on school level, right? So we will discuss some of that. We will discuss this in more detail. We will go through different projects. Okay, we just discussed one project, but there are other projects as well, as Arav might be aware that, I don't want about.
Hello, sir.
We discussed last time that there are different kinds of machine learning projects, right? Here?
Yes, sir.
So what you can, Divyanshu, what you can see is here, you can make it text-based, you can make an AI chatbot. It responds according to what label do you give.
Yes, sir.
You can do it with images. Images will be fun in like anything. Okay, let's come up with some example for images. What we can do with images, okay, machine learning for images. Sorry.
Sir.
Yes, Arav, you were saying something, then your voice broke off. Arav, you are not audible. Okay. Okay, Divyanshu, weekend numbers, we have seen it. Numbers is nothing but you just keep track of some numbers. I just took four numbers, you can take n number of numbers. But the number of variables that you will increase in the machine learning will obviously impact how much accurate you are. Because if the variables are too large, then you have to feed it a lot of data. If you have two variables, then 200 data will work fine. But if you have like 20 variables, you have to feed it like 2 lakh or something, some kind of that amount of data. Sounds, I was trying to do sounds, but as this is developed by UK people, so what the sound texture they have is very different to what Indians have. So sounds does not work that good, but we will do these projects in Python and there we will see how sounds works. Okay. So any other questions that you would like to know in machine learning, in CES?
No, sir.
No, sir.
What are your guys' plans in later on in life? Why did you take CES?
Sir, to opt for software engineering.
To opt for software engineering. Okay, what specific field in software engineering? Anything you have?
Sir, game developer.
Game developer. Okay. Game developers. Okay. Okay.
Sir, man, कभी इतना सोचा नहीं.
Sir, मैंने game भी बनाया है.
Game भी बनाया किस चीज पे?
Sir, एक happy birds और एक snake का game है in Python.
I meant कि कौन सा platform को use कर, क्या use करके आप करते हैं? Infinity.
What sir?
क्या क्या use किया आपने game बनाने
के? Sir, Python.
Sorry, please repeat. Yes, Arav, what did you use?
Python.
Python?
Yes, sir.
Python, okay. That is nice. Okay, so your...
Sir, shall I show you?
I don't think your screen sharing is allowed here. But we will see. Okay. You are in 12th class or something, Arav? Why? How, are you learning Python on your own? Or did your school guide you?
What, sir?
मैं ये पूछ रहा था कि आपने जो गेम बनाया वो आपने स्कूल में बनवाया या आप घर पे बैठे थे तो ऐसे ही वर डूइंग इट ऑन योर ओन?
तो खुद बनाया, मतलब जैसे यूट्यूब से करके।
That's how we'll do. You guys live in a very very good time. You have a lot of information. All right, I guess we will close down this session. Divyanshu, you have okay. You can okay. You are sharing a screen with your phone. Okay, all right. Yes, show me. I'll just.
It's a Flappy Bird game.
Let me just try to. How do I?
So it's like this. And so when you touch these pipes, you lose.
What is coming on the left? Score.
The what?
Score is coming. Okay. 1, 2.
Yes, sir.
Score is the number of pipes that you have passed, right?
That yes, sir.
And how does it identify that the pipe has passed? What is the logic?
Sir, it uses a sense. Here's the code. So it uses some.
It uses some language.
What we...
That is using random local and. I can barely read anything. Not really visible. Basic PyGram input. Py game. Okay, you have used Py game. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, got it. Okay, Divyanshu. So, what are your plans? Your plans is to become software engineer. And
yes, sir.
So when is this also?
Presented.
So it has a background song also. So and when you press enter, this black square is you, and that red square is the food that you need to eat. So if you move with the control, then you have to eat it and.
But you're not eating it.
Yes, sir. Now it's.
Okay.
So, sir, your score is coming. And that last score you made.
Okay. So, okay. So, okay. For both of you guys, if you can find some games or anything that you like over the internet and you can develop it, of course, try to play around with the code. And you will learn more about the code than just copying it from internet. You will love it. When you play around with the code, your program will crash sometimes. So always make a backup copy. But you will find how it works. And it will be fun for you. So, okay, we'll take up what programming is in different lectures because it's a big topic in itself. So yes, Divyanshu, so are you doing something like this as well?
No, sir, not yet.
Not yet? Okay. So, but your school has started Python?
No, sir. Sir, abhi to bas matlab binary language padhaya thoda bahut.
Binary language?
Normal language ko kaise binary mein convert karte, ye bataya abhi.
Yes, that is important because yeah. For now, at least for now, अभी जो हम current times में हैं, उसमें computer सिर्फ और सिर्फ binary समझता है. It might move on to quantum later on, but it will take some time.
Okay. Yes.
Now अभी तो binary है हमारे पास. Okay, so you are learning binary. What else?
Sir, मतलब अभी तो मतलब मैम ने बताया है कि कैसे जो हम भी data put करते हैं उसको zeros और ones के form में कन्वर्ट किया जाता है. वीए से भी बताया सर, अभी आगे ज्यादा नहीं पढ़ा. अभी पिछले लास्ट वीक से ही क्लासेस हमारी स्टार्ट हुई हैं.
हां, तो अभी तो आप बाइनरी पढ़ेंगे, देन यू विल लर्न सम स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्रोग्रामिंग. सो प्रोग्रामिंग, इफ यू गाइस हैव 5-7 मिनट्स मोर देन आई कैन डिस्कस प्रोग्रामिंग, अदरवाइज वी कैन जस्ट वाइंड इट अप राइट नाउ.
यस सर.
बट प्रोग्रामिंग इज मेनली इसकी प्रोग्राम में आपको क्या करना होता है, यू ऑलवेज हैव अ टास्क एट हैंड, राइट? आपको कुछ करना होता है, दैट इज व्हाई यू आर राइटिंग अ प्रोग्राम फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. सो पॉइंट ये है कि आप प्रोग्राम को कितना डिवाइड कर सकते हो. इफ यू मतलब books will have a lot of bad examples as well, how to make tea and things like that. Matlab they were there when I was in school. So, but aapko apne thoughts ko divide karna hota hai. Kitne choti choti problem mein aap divide kar sakte hain. Jitna jaldi aap divide kar sakenge, utni jaldi aap usko acche tarike se kar sakte hain. Utna jaldi aap program bana sakte hain. That is what programming is, right? If I have to talk to you about machine learning, then I have to divide my mind or my structure of course into different parts, right? I'll divide into what machine is, what learning is, how machine learning works, and things like that. It's not a single package, right?
Yes, sir.
अपना प्रोग्राम से आरब भी बता रहे हो तो आरब हैड टू टेल मी कि ये प्रोग्राम यहाँ से स्टार्ट होता है, इसमें ये होता है, ये मैं यूज कर रहा हूँ, ये मैं यूज नहीं कर रहा हूँ. सो उसमें बहुत कुछ है. तो आप अपने थॉट्स को ब्रेक डाउन करना, जिसको हम लोग क्रिटिकल थिंकिंग कहते हैं, कहेंगे टू फाइंड पैटर्न्स टू ब्रेक इट डाउन इनटू थिंग्स. तो वो जिस दिन आप करना सीखेंगे उस दिन यू विल बी आप प्रोग्राम करना एकदम से सीख जाएंगे. प्रोग्रामिंग इज ऑल अबाउट हाउ मच यू कैन ब्रेक डाउन थिंग्स. तो जैसे ही आप ब्रेक डाउन करने लग जाएंगे वैसे ही प्रोग्रामिंग आपको समझ आ जाती है, क्योंकि कंप्यूटर्स आर डम्ब मशीन. दे डोंट नो एनीथिंग एक्सेप्ट एवरीथिंग दैट यू हैव टोल्ड देम, राइट? सो कंप्यूटर्स को समझाने के लिए आपको चीजें ब्रेक डाउन करनी. दैट्स व्हाई बाइनरी, यू शुड नो व्हाट बाइनरी इज, बिकॉज अगर आप लेट्स से कंप्यूटर साइंस में इन फ्यूचर यू गो टू दी हार्डवेयर पार्ट, देन यू नीड टू नो व्हाट बाइनरी इज, हाउ इट वर्क्स, हाउ डज योर ट्रांजिस्टर्स एंड योर गेट्स वर्क, राइट? सो प्रोग्रामिंग पे हम बात करेंगे इन टर्म्स ऑफ पाइथन, इन टर्म्स ऑफ डिफरेंट पैराडाइम्स ऑफ प्रोग्रामिंग की ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग क्या होती है, थिंग्स लाइक दैट. बट अभी फिलहाल प्रोग्रामिंग से भी ये समझो है आपकी कैसे मुझे कंप्यूटर से बात करनी है. जो आप बोलेंगे वो कंप्यूटर करेगा, बस. आप गलत बोलेंगे वो नहीं कर पाएगा. दैट इज हाउ इट इज, ठीक?
यस सर.
ओके सर.
Keep playing around with codes, keep finding new things that you want. I will help you out guys as much as you want. And हमारे पास एक डेढ़ घंटा है होता ही हफ्ते में, जो which we can discuss anything that you want to. We will keep it limited to machine learning, otherwise we won't be learning much. But if you have some other questions, you can come up for conversations. That's my only thing at that time. All right. I think you guys will have some dinner and I will have some dinner as well now.
Yes, sir.
Good night for today. See you next Tuesday, hopefully. If today's session wasn't too boring or something like that. But we'll see.
No, sir, it wasn't.
Next week we'll see.
It was.
Okay, thank you. And we'll see each other next week. And we will discuss Python in some detail. Right?
Yes, nice, sir. Okay, sir.
Thank you.
You're welcome.